Mr. Andy Brown. He's a postmaster. Andy is excited to be evaluating Isabel and her icebreaker. Andy hopes to do half as well with Isabel's evaluation as she did with her speech. Please welcome Andy Brown.
All I really want to say is wow. Everybody know exactly where I'm coming from? Mm.
Yes.
This did not feel like an icebreaker speech for a brand new Toastmaster. This felt to me like a speech from an experienced presenter, someone who used to be behind the lectern. Isabel, when I'm evaluating an icebreaker, I'm watching for signs of nervousness. You definitely looked a little nervous when you got up here. For about a second and a half. As soon as we got to 1.51 seconds, it looked as though you were born to be up here. You had expressiveness and vocal variety and gestures and eye contact and audience contact that just looked like you had really, almost like you were a ringer. You've done this before. You were born to be up here. You had speech, I want to say tools, there's another word that escapes me at the moment, but just effects like when you went, my belly was hard as a rock. That's not something you normally see in Toastmasters. It was just so natural and didn't look rehearsed or anything. Some of the visuals we had, called my husband, I said, whoa, take a shower. We all had this impression that he went, I don't want you getting kicked out of the labor room because you're covered in insulation. It was wonderful. It was exactly what's supposed to be in a speech. Icebreakers, here's something to think about. Icebreakers really serve two purposes. There's the one that's in your manual, which is getting you up here for your first time, getting used to public speaking. The other one is giving us a chance to get to know our new member. You started off really well with giving us information about you. We learned the names of your brothers and sisters, and I believe I wrote them down correctly. John, Bill, Rick. Gidget was the last one. Turned into more of a story and a speech about your delivery day. Now, this is not a criticism. This speech and all the elements that you brought to the table, the lectern, it would be worthy of entering into the humorous speech contest. The organizational structure you brought, the flow, the elements, the humorous elements, or any of a number of upcoming projects that you're going to find in your manual. For our sake, because you are just so powerful up here, I think I'm speaking for the entire group, we would love it if you would take some of the upcoming speeches in your manual, this confident communicator one, and it's very specific with its intention and the outline and the order, and give us more information about you, growing up, what you were into, let us know a little bit more about you, but please weave it into this wonderful style and delivery you have. All I can say is, I'm so glad you remember, and I can't wait to see more speeches. Well done.